Greetings, Virtual Beach Blast. My name is Chris Stryker Curtis, and it's my extreme pleasure to announce for you today your 2020 Virtual F-14B demonstration. There it is, at show right, the mighty Tomcat. Claws out low level. Ladies and gentlemen, the F-14B demonstration. Travis Bovino is now going into full runner, pitching back on the stick there. Listen to that sound of the mighty Tomcat at work. Take note of the orange glow of the afterburner can, indicating that full afterburner has been selected. While in full afterburner, the Tomcat will burn over 2,000 pounds or 300 gallons of fuel per minute as he wakes his way back around to show center. Ladies and gentlemen, Bo and Fergie in the mighty Tomcat and the flat eight. Listen to that roar and noise as he goes around for the first part of that maneuver. Coming back now to show left, he's going to roll out and reverse turn to the right to complete this maneuver. Bo doing an excellent job keeping that altitude right on the line as he makes his way back to show center to complete the flat eight. Plenty more here for you as the Tomcat demonstration is just getting started. Teed up into the vertical. Travis Bovino is commanding this mighty demonstration as the Tomcat now setting up to approach from the right for a top-down view pass. The degree of sweep of the variable geometry wing is controlled by a mock sweep programmer. The wings fully forward are at 20 degrees of sweep, full aft, 68 degrees. At 300 miles per hour, correction 350 miles per hour, Bo will roll the F-14 at a 100-degree angle of bank, overriding the computer while manually selecting full aft wing sweep. There it is, the Tomcat wing sweep pass. As you just saw, the Tomcat is a highly sophisticated aircraft. Its operational envelope extends from the deck to over 50,000 feet, from zero airspeed to twice the speed of sound. It's the variable geometry wings that enable the Tomcat to maneuver throughout this envelope. At slow speeds, the wings move forward. At high speeds, well, they program aft. This next pass against demonstrates the various wing sweeps of the mighty F-14. Bo will perform a slow roll at 350 miles per hour with the wings at full sweep, or 68 degrees. During the roll, he will manually select minimum sweep, and the wings will move forward to the 20-degree position. From the left, it's your slow roll and unsweep. Completing the maneuver. There he goes, pitching back into the vertical for a full 2 and 8. Let's see. Possibly flares on top. There's 1, 2, 3, 4 on top as he comes back, apexing. Going back on his down line, reversing to show left. Raw power of the F-14 on display once again, back in the vertical. More flares, I bet, on the left side now. Watch him any second. As Bo and Fergie inverted, AM strap now rolling out on the down line, back finishing the Cuban ace. What do you think, folks? Now the Tomcat, well, it's getting ready to approach from the right once again. Bo and Fergie are configuring the bird to demonstrate the slow speed handling characteristics of the F-14. The huge surface area of the two independently operating horizontal ailerons and vertical tails, combined with the tremendous thrust produced by the two engines is especially effective in maneuvering the aircraft at slow speeds and in approach to a carrier. As the Tomcat draws closer, notice the bow, well, he'll configure the F-14 with the tail hook down. There he is approaching from the right as it's the tail hook that separates the Navy and Marine Corps tactical aircraft from the rest of the world's tactical aircraft, permitting them to land on a carrier and stop on a very exciting, get this folks, 300 feet. As Bo now approaches the center point, he'll take a simulated wave off, command full afterburner, and accelerate away from the deck. And just listen to that noise. How about that for raw power? Now from show left and at 350 miles per hour, Bo and Bernie will demonstrate the Tomcat's extreme tight turning capability. Even with the enormous size of this airplane, as we're seeing, its turn radius is only a quarter of a mile. In the turn, the aircrew will be slammed into their seats at 7 Gs, or 7 times the force of gravity. It's the ability to outturn and outgun your opponent that determines the victor in aerial combat. As Bo and Fergie setting up show left for the maximum radius turn, or the MRT, as it's fly to fight and fight to win. Not done yet. Watch as he rolls out. Pulls once again for the mighty power of the Tomcat to be demonstrated once more at show left. Being swept back, the Tomcat outbound in a hurry. And now, ladies and gentlemen, this next pass, well, it's dedicated to our men and women serving in the military, to all those that give their lives in the defense of their nation, to all the family members who have supported them. The F-14 continuing to accelerate in the turn now, approaching the speed of sound, as they say. It passes, it will be traveling at 650 miles per hour. Let's get those cameras and earplugs ready. From show right, the dedication pass and vertical departure. A lot of G now into the vertical at that speed. Bo Dickens upstairs, the Gordon Bird in here in a second, and pulling hard to reverse back to show center. Navy Coast Guard panic. No, he's the Navy. They're the Coast Guard. He buzzed them. That's what we're talking about there. Little play on the words, but you've been in the military, served in the branches. We love to taunt each other there. It's the Tomcat now slowing to 125. Well, not yet to 125, but he'll be getting there soon. This maneuver is utilized to slow the aircraft from 600 to ultimately 125 miles an hour and give the crew time to set the landing configuration. As they approach, watch as the Tomcat climbs quickly. He's gonna roll right and turn left for the tuck under brake. Not easy to do there with the wings commanded aft. Very nicely done as he's setting up for the next passage. slowing that aircraft down to, like you said, 125 miles per hour. We're going to listen closely, make sure the precise power changes required of the simulated precision approach to an aircraft carrier. The deck, again, has four wires spaced every 45 feet, any one of which the tailhook can engage immediately upon touchdown to the pilot. He's going to add full power, and it's the arresting gear, not the wheel brakes, ladies and gentlemen, that stops the plane in the unlikely event of a bolter. If the hook should skip and miss all four wires, the crew takes off and goes around for another try. Let's tune in now to the LSO.
One 6 and a 3/4. I'll call the ball. Gunfighter 160 and Tomcat Fall 8.1. Roger, ball, touch and go. Touch and go, 160. Cocktail.
The LSO and Bo, they confirmed they'll perform a touch and go. Gear extended to perform a vertical climb and dirty double element here shortly, demonstrating the power and superb slow speed handling characteristics. There it is on the F-14. Ladies and gentlemen, Travis Bo, you know, he goes in the back birdie with the dirty double. Gear extended and out. He's still rolling out. Back in the climb here in a second. He is not done yet. Hear the roar of the Tomcat. It makes its way back on top here.
And let's go inside the cockpit with Fergie. This is Stryker at Show Center. Are you there, sir? Yeah, thanks, Stryker. Happy to be here with you in the best seat in the house at Virtual Beach Blast 2020. We want to say a huge thank you to the airshow staff for making it all happen. Boda, I'd also like to take a minute to dedicate this performance to everyone's favorite married couple, Sticky and Fidel of Fidel's L39 demo team. Remember, folks, when it absolutely positively must be shot down or blown up overnight, your Tomcats will be there on time and on target. Now it's time to gather small children and take your belongings, because your Tomcat is inbound at the speed of heat.
Well said there, Fergie. The speed of heat is exactly what that aircraft is at right now, as we can see it now inbound. Hang on, ladies and gentlemen. This one might be a little faster, as the speed of the Tomcat is demonstrated at show left. Goodbye, Tomcat, and goodbye to my windows there as my car alarm and everybody else's just went off. And, hey, you know what, folks? It's a rental. We'll get through this. What? I'm not covered? Okay, we'll have to deal with that later. All right, with its air-to-air and air-to-ground capability, the Tomcat, when it was in service, remained the most versatile multi-mission fighter in the United States Navy. Grumman Aerospace built 712 Tomcats, with the first fleet squadrons deploying back in 1972. At the time of its retirement, it has become the longest-serving fighter in the history of the United States Navy. Ladies and gentlemen, look close. Bo and Fergie wish to thank you for stopping by, watching this amazing aircraft as the Tomcat prepares to, well, I guess, finish out here for virtual...